Its victory is at hand! This night, the land will be stained with the blood of Rohan! March to Helm's Deep! Leave none alive! To war!
Intro is relatively epic. Okay, hello and welcome back to Third Age Total War. This is gonna be slightly different. Basically, I decided to install a sub mod for Third Age, which was a fantastic idea until I realized it actually allowed me to finish off the Fellowship campaign that started previously. The game's still saved, so I'm going to obviously come back to that at some point, but for the time being we're going to play this one. Now, this is called Divide and Conquer. I'll put a link in the description below, as obviously as always. It's a mod that basically expands on what Third Age did before, has a new map, new territories, new factions. They've kind of divided up certain factions that were once sort of together, for instance, Dol Guldur and Mordor. And also, it is fairly in depth compared to what Third Age was. They've taken a lot of time to balance it out. Unfortunately, there is no Fellowship campaign, which is a slight annoyance because I was hoping to kind of get there. But well, as I said, I've saved the save game away. So what I'll do is we'll do a campaign on this, maybe a few more, come back to the Third Age one, or if I can, I'll just put a clean version of Third Age Total War in the mod folder, and we can just jump back and forward. But yeah, without further ado, so we got like a rough idea of the rules and so on of the game here. They, as I said, are far more in depth, but I mean, the owner of the mod does some fantastic videos regarding the actual factions and so on. It's much better than what I can do when it comes to that, so I'm going to base this solely on the idea that we're just going to play through the game and see how far we get. So as you can see, we've chosen Isengard to be our first faction to play as. That's Will's fault. He just told me to play as them. I have no idea why. It was just the first one that came to his mind, I think. So this is where we're going to go. I had a few ideas of who I wanted to start with, but I think Isengard's as good as any. Also because it's one of the more difficult ones to start off with because it's completely alone. So we get a... Oh, let's have a look. So we get a rough sort of story idea. I have sort of read through this before, so if you want to pause the game and have a look, feel free. Sorry, pause the video, not the game. Feel free, and I'll just slowly scroll through so you can grab it as we go. Okay. So the starting point for Isengard is pretty straightforward. Okay. Cool. Okay, so basically Isengard starts off with just Tower of Orthanc and the Vale of Isengard. They get nothing else. They are allied to, I think, only... hold on a minute, let's look. Yeah, they're allied only to Dunland. So at this point, he hasn't actually... Like, Saruman hasn't actually declared himself as a... as basically in league with Mordor. This kind of opens up a unique opportunity though, because it actually means that we could take things in a different direction. What if Saruman didn't turn evil? That's just too easy. No, I think we'll follow a certain pattern, or maybe actually try and get somewhere rather than kind of ruin things a little bit. So yeah, we have Isengard. The only people we're at war with is the rebels, as always, and Fangorn. So basically the Ents, which I think, I'm guessing around here, but in all fairness, I'm assuming that's Fangorn Forest. And if Lothlorien would be there. Okay, yeah. So that is Fangorn. So that'll be where we're at war At the moment, but that's all we are at war with, so it keeps things pretty simple in that respect. So what we will do is the game has a first turn expansion, so the rest of the rest of the factions will basically start their first turn. The AI will move to where they need to move, and certain things are already scripted. As I said, if you look at some of the videos, I'll put, again, links in the description below. I mean, watching these videos and being absolutely fascinated by how well this mod has been put together, and how it kind of takes what the Third Age did and makes it so much more, more muchiness, as you would say. And basically, it kind of expands a lot on what was put there before, and also kind of adds a lot more to it as well, including sort of a lot of the book elements, which even the Third Age didn't shy away from it, didn't kind of go too over the top with it. The map is huge compared to the previous map and how that looked. It's just massive. I mean, Mordor is at least twice the size of what it was previously. It is it's just a massive map. It's incredible to see. So we're gonna, obviously, we're gonna play as Isengard, so we're gonna see how far we get with this. Now, I haven't played Total War game properly in terms of actually playing a game, not the Fellowship idea, for a while. So if I just, you know, sort of bumble about a little bit, then just excuse me, I'm gonna have to get back into this again. I think our first move, however, is to take some rebel villages. I think Rohan are probably going to try and expand out this way, if they expand at all. I don't actually know how much they own. I'm going to try and keep the fog of war on as much as possible and not cheat, because in all fairness, just kind of want to play it as it would, it's intended to be played, for instance. So what we'll do is we will expand this way. I'm sure Dunland will be around here somewhere, so I think it's probably a good idea for us to get contact with as quickly as possible. So let's have a look at what we have to start with. So we have a Gluck, so he is inhabiting a fort here, which is strange here in a rebel territory, so I'm not sure how that works out. He has some Uruks, but they are just the basic Urukai, nothing too special. Saruman has some Urukai infantry, but other than that he has just archers and raiders. Which I suppose at this point is kind of right. I mean, I think we're talking sort of Fellowship of the Ring. Potentially Gandalf is either on the way or is already sat at the top of Orthanc at the moment. So I think we're around about that sort of period of time. So in that respect, I think probably is right for him to have a very basic army. He's just started breeding them, and sort of the bulk of it, I think, will be mainly sort of basic Orcs and Orcs. So we're not going to win any awards for the greatest army at the moment, but we'll see what we can do. I mean, I don't know what we can currently recruit. Let's have a look. So we can get some berserkers. Well, we can get one unit of berserkers. Guards of Orthanc, but they are really expensive. So let's have a look. Snagger. They're awful. They are terrible. We can get some Dunland. Men of Dunland. Beast Slayers. Horsemen. I think we'll just sort of sit with what we have at the moment. Let's see if we can build anything. What do we get from that? Urukai bodyguards. Fire network. I think our main thing we need to do is, I mean, Isengard is our only base operation, so we need to get ourselves as much money as possible. So I think, personally, that we will need to go with the mining network. So it's going to take a fair chunk of our amount, but it's going to add quite a bit to our income. So I think it's a good idea for us to do that. So we'll go with that first. Let's add that on there. It's going to take 6 turns, so it's not going to be here tomorrow, but we'll see how we go. So let's get the first turn over with. Actually, in our fairness, I think let's take some of these guys and let's... Oh, we got another fort over here. Oh, hold on. Ah, so that's where Lertz is. I was wondering if he was going to be in the game. Okay, so Raiders. How good are these guys? Oh, they're not terrible. Vanguard. Okay, oh, they're half orcs. Creepy looking. we take some archers, some raiders, because they are kind of, you know, the basics. This doesn't look defended, in all fairness, so we'll just jump over there and see what happens. Okay. So let's occupy this settlement. Okay, so that gives us a little bit more to play with, I suppose, in some respects. So what can we build here? Absolutely nothing. Moment. I think we need to wait a little bit longer. Okay, so let's... we'll end the turn this time, because I don't really know where the next settlement is. I think... Sure, to be honest. Okay, let's end the turn, and let's just see what else happens. So let's just jump on it. As you can see from the top, there is significantly more in the way of factions than we had previously in this game. A dramatic amount. Remnants of Agmar, you've got Calmed, which is obviously broken off from Arad. They also have the Corsairs as a separate faction as well. And a lot of these are separate factions as well, so for instance the Isengard faction, the Corsairs are not actually involved in the war from the start, so if you actually play as those factions, then obviously you can take things the other way. And if you are obviously playing as another faction, potentially the AI could take it the other way as well. They don't, most of them are scripted, but not always, and there is like a percentage chance that they may not even join the war, or that they'll actually join on your side, so you never know. It means that it's actually worth playing, unlike obviously beforehand, where you kind of knew what the outcome was going to be and who was going to be at war, and they were kind of locked in that respect as well. So, okay. Lawmaster of Imladris. With the death of the late Lawmaster of Imladris, his heir has succeeded to the renowned position. The lords know whether to find fear or comfort in this knowledge. Oh, I'm not sure at all. Warrior reclaimed. Moria has been reclaimed, fires burn in its depths, torches light the paths of the Dwaradelph, and the cheers of the victorious echo through the misty mountains. Those who gave their lives to defend her before she was lost have been properly laid to rest, and a calming peace falls on the ancient mountain city. Okay, any more? Ithilien has been reclaimed, so the lands surrounding the Iman Arnon have been swept clear of enemy forces. The fighting was fierce, yet the might of Gondor prevailed. The brave soldiers fought with the courage and skill their forefathers of old. This is a day of celebration. The enemy have paid dearly, and many of the warriors lie dead, strewn between the hills and the surrounding woodlands. With the enemy vanquished, the bases within Emin Arnon will once again become the staging area for forays into the forest of Ithilien and beyond. Okay, so that's kind of, I think that's kind of dealing with the initial expansion. So Gondor has moved into Ithilien over here. We actually get told about that as well, so it's actually given us the details there as well, so that's where they've moved into. What was the other one? Oh, and also Moria has been reclaimed by the dwarves. I wonder if that shows on here as well. Three peaks. Yeah, and so we can also see that Moria has also been reclaimed. Now, from what I remember, there is actually two halves. So there's an east and a western half of Khazad-dûm. So I'm assuming, I think the dwarves start with one half, because there's actually a dwarven faction based in Khazad-dûm, so I think it's literally starting when Balin has literally just begun his attack. So from what I can assume, they've now taken both halves, and now own the entire of that mountain pass. Obviously history tells us that that isn't going to remain that way for all long, unless of course the game manages to play out differently, but that's currently there. So that pass is now controlled by the forces of good. So obviously we are now in control of this pass entirely. We now own the Gap of Rohan pretty much. There isn't really any way through. There's only one pathway across, which I think is... Oh, I don't know if I can see. Where is the path towards the Isen? Is it there? Or is it further? I'm not really sure, to be honest. But there is only one crossing, as far as I'm aware, across the Isen. We control it. pretty much. I mean, we're not effectively at war with Rohan yet, but obviously that is something that I imagine will come with time. I'm not sure if they'll declare war on us or the other way around, but for the time being, I think we should stick to expansion. We need to get as much money behind us as we possibly can. So let's see if we can build anything here now. It looks like it's being held for us. Raider camp and hunting. Do we get money for that? Improve food production. Okay, we'll leave that one. And that allows us new recruitment slots. What can we get soldier-wise? We can't get anything yet. We haven't built anything here, I don't think. Yeah, we just have a road and just the fact that we own the Gap of Rohan. Is that saying the same thing as well? Yeah. So, let's see what else we can do here then. So, Ballista Maker, Leather Tanner, what's that? So, Ballista Maker, obviously, allows us to build the ballistas, simple as that. Warg Breeder allows us to build wargs. Leather Tanner allows us to upgrade the armor. Logging House increases tradable goods. I don't know if we're going to be doing much trading, in all fairness. Chieftain's Hall allows us to build bodyguards. And I imagine probably gives us the ability to build the next level, or am I sort of losing there? Guards of Wolf. Okay, we can retrain them. Why not? So is it worth us maybe starting to build a few? I mean, we don't have any of the actual Urukai yet. So what we'll do, I think, because we'll stick to the raiders for now. It kind of seems legit given the sort of time period we're in at the moment. So let's Urukai raiders. We'll have a unit of those, and we'll have some archers as well. So we'll just sort of fill up the ranks of Isengard so we can send out some parties. And in the meantime, let me gather up you guys. I think we'll send you further south.
Come on! We have completed an objective!
All for you. That sort of leaves the same sort of group there in each one of these, so we just have to be careful that Rohan don't decide to attack. But, I mean, we have plenty in the way of reinforcements, if necessary, so we should be okay. Grima.
Can I help, my lord?
That was definitely the Malfazaran accent. That's quite confusing. And we found the Gap of Rohan, so that's where the Fords of the Eisen is. It's just there. So, just keep an eye on that. I kind of feel like I want to talk to Rohan and just see where we sit with them. So let's...
Opening talks with the foreigners.
It's kind of like the mouth of Sauron with a slightly more German or maybe Scandinavian accent. I'm not entirely sure. That's a little bit weird. Okay, so let's see where we stand with Rohan.
What is it you wish to discuss?
So, they don't feel particularly upset about us. So if we set up a trade agreement with them, I'm not going to say it's going to last for particularly long, but I mean, potentially it's worth doing, given the circumstances at the moment. We need to make as much money as possible, and the irony being that we make money off them before we wipe them out. So, anything else that we could do? Perhaps some map information? What's some map information? No, they're not going to take that, are they? Let's just stay there. We'll make ourselves sort of known, and we'll hopefully build up some... We'll hopefully build up our reputation with them over time. So that should hopefully give us a little bit... a chance at getting something.
This seems quite reasonable.
Awesome. Okay, so we have trade rights with Rohan.
An honor and a pleasure. Farewell.
Strange as that is. I'm also going to do the same. Oh, I think we already have a trade agreement with Dunland. Judging by this. So that might actually be not too bad. I think we need a trade agreement with... I'm going to try and get to Dol Guldur. I'm going to try and set up a trade agreement with them up north and see if there's any other...
Without question, my lord.
Anyone else on the way there that we could potentially use as well. Okay, so in the meantime, let's end this turn as well and see where we get. So we've got Dol Amroth as well, by the look of it. Dol Amroth. So what they've seemingly done is, so for instance on Third Age, if you played as, for instance, the elves of Rivendell, we'd also get the elves of the Blue Mountains and the Grey Havens. If you played as the dwarves, you'd get multiple dwarf. Okay, let's have a look. There are foreigners almost at our very gates, and we know very little about them. The council suggests you send an emissary to this faction and initiate Clan of Eden away. Are you sure where they are, in all fairness? Okay, so our troops are starting to flood in slowly. Alliance now, it's between... Okay. Seems slightly unusual. I'm assuming that Flanduil is still in charge of the Woodland Realm, but apparently he's okay with the dwarves now. Okay, so I'm not sure where the Eden Wafers.
An honor, Lord.
Some of this way. Sure. Let's just see what happens.
At once. Stopping here.
In the meantime, you need to. Is it here? Get across.
Move!
Are you gonna have to go that way around? Oh.
Objective complete.
Fantastic. Anything else that we can pick up? Sort of missing. We can get another diplomat. Not sure who this will be. I'm guessing not Grima. That'll take. What will that be? One turn. We may as well. We can send them west. Cover both bases then. It makes life a little bit easier. What's he doing? Come on, special eye raven on those. Oh, okay, so it adds line of sight. Okay, cool. Anything else that we can do this turn? Anything? No. It's gonna be one of those really slow starts. That we're going to have to slowly but surely work our way up. But I think the easiest way of doing this is to kind of play the good card for a little while before we decide to attack anyone. We can't really afford to be at war with anyone because we haven't really got the infrastructure to have a grand army. And with Rohan so close and with them having so much cavalry, which will probably be our main weakness until we get army troops, we can't particularly afford...
Get ready for fighting! Come on!
Okay, that's not... Okay, it's there. Ooh, that's quite a big rebel army. Let's... Grab our agent.
Can Oshnaz. I help, my lord?
Oshnaz? Alright, we'll send you west.
Tomorrow's journey awaits.
I'm actually giving a different... Pretty cool.
Yes.
Didn't really expect that. Okay. Oh, we've bogged. Still got. I'm not really sure how we're going to cross the end. Do we go away to the north? It's our way of crossing our boats. We'll find out.
Yes.
Find out soon
Stopping
enough.
Here.
In the meantime, we need to reinforce this army here. So. Grab up some Uruk-hai infantry because they are reasonably powerful. Some raiders. Oh, hang on. Some archers. That for now. Bring you guys down here.
We have completed an objective.
I think I might put Lurtz in charge of this. I need some. I need to get some experience.
We have completed an objective.
And we're not exactly going to be chasing down the ring bearer for a little while. I'm not even sure when that's going to be the case. Okay, so anything else we can do? Starting to build up a nice healthy pot of money, so I'm starting to wonder whether it's worth us going for the Chieftain's Hall. Or maybe we should get some cavalry. Oh, we'll go with wargs. We'll go with wargs, we'll do that. Okay, let's jump in. So, let's end the turn again. Let's go. That was worrying. So, Rohan are sending... Is that Rohan? I think it is. They're sending troops north. I'm assuming in that case they must be helping with the war on Dol Guldur.
Ambush!
I've never really played a game of Total War where my income is this healthy at the beginning. Not really sure what to do with myself. Levitanel. That gave us an armor upgrade, didn't it? Maybe it's worth doing that as well. Jumping with that as well. Get some more armor. These guys have built theirs now, so we'll put down the hunting hut. And we can now start building some raiders. So these are literally just, I think, orcs. Are they not? Yeah. So if we jump in with... We'll just buy a couple of each. They're cheap. And we can start bolstering our forces here as well. Right, Lertz needs to join there. You guys need to join there as well. Okay, let's jump on it. Ah, thought that was going to be the case. Okay, Screamer. Is this a Rohan arm? It is, right here I come.
Can I help, my lord?
What are you doing up here? Almost more intrigued by that, to be honest. I would have thought they'd have more. Well, actually, no. In fairness, they haven't got any troubles on their own borders, because that's what we're doing. Ah, they must be trying to take this. That makes more sense. Okay, let's jump on. Yep, there they are. Oh, I like the animation for the sieges, that's brilliant. Is that in top? Was that in medieval too? Okay, so Rohan are taken sort of north of their lands. So, quite impressively, it actually gives you quite a bit of expansion in these areas. I know Gondor is very much Gondor by the time you start. They own pretty much all the land south of the White Mountains. So, other than obviously Dol Amroth. So, yeah. It's quite nice that you actually have something to do at the beginning. Okay, so the Vale of Anduin and the Orcs of the Misty Mountains have actually declared a ceasefire. I'm guessing they're getting a hammering from the dwarves at the moment, so that's probably what. Raider Warband. They're ready for us. And we're still making a ton of money, which is always nice. Okay. Let's continue our journey. I've got to find a way of crossing the Anduin. Hopefully if I take here.
At once.
Aha! That's set the path. Perfect. Okay, so let's begin our first battle. Not really sure how well this is going to go.
Tomorrow's journey. Get ready for fighting! Attack! Destroy them!
Okay, so they've got pretty good defences, actually. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so we're actually going to have to build a reasonable amount of siege equipment. So if we go for ladders, get as many as we can in a single turn, and maintain it.
Is that what you want?
I do like this animation. Or placeholder, I suppose. It looks really good. Okay, Isengard. How are we doing on our mines? One more turn, perfect. Now we need to build war breeders, Levitanar, just a looking house. Hopefully we'll be able to upgrade the type of soldiers we have soon. Yeah, I don't really want to go into the snaggers because they are just awful. I mean, look. Just terrible. I don't want to bother with them. Uruk Reavers. Seen any of those yet? I'll grab some of those, or one of those. And Guards of Orthanc, they just look worth having. In fairness, we'll grab a set. Okay. Send our diplomat, which I've just completely forgotten about. So if anyone's me shouting at the screen, do excuse me. We need to find Eden Wave, don't we? So let's
without question,
run this way.
Stopping here.
Is that? I'm not really sure where they are, to be honest. Okay, let's end the turn. Let's just go. Well, well and good then to give me a mission to do this, but I have the Fog of War in. I don't know who any of these people are. Okay, cool, Leo. You probably didn't even see anything there, so I do apologise. But a bit of a crash, and you guys probably didn't even notice it, but I've just had to start the back into the game again. Which is fine, we're all back, we're all fine here, don't worry about it. So, we were just about to attack this place.
Listen up!
So everything is now built and ready. So, let's jump on it. Our first fight. I think we may be alright, but we are going to play this on a battle map because these games tend to be quite unforgiving when it comes to resolving. Should we attempt a night attack? Does that make any difference to... No. I kind of want to see it in all fairness, so we'll fight on the battle map. Let's go for it. I must admit, compared to the other version of Third Age, the artwork on this is absolutely phenomenal. The loading screens are actually worth looking at. I haven't seen any twice either, to be honest. They just look amazing. Okay, so are we going to get a little speech? Is that going to happen? I know they used to do that in the old game. Doesn't seem like it. So let's just get our
Stay alert!
So let's see what we have. Oh, hold on a minute. Nothing worse than having a restricted camera. So let's see what we have to deal with here. Okay, so the wall we're attacking is this one here. So we have the gate. I'm not really sure how many men they've got to defend it with, so I'm not sure how much of an issue this is going to be to take. But I think most of our free men are archers. In fact, all of our free men are archers, other than the group of berserkers that are with... Oh, hold on, who are these? Oh, okay, so they haven't actually got their armor yet. So they will look like that, but at the moment they don't, so they're just a group of berserkers. Okay, so we have our archers up here. So I think the idea would be to bring these guys quite far forward. Kind of skirmish it out. I'm not sure how good their range is, but hopefully they're about to take out a few guys. It's also... Right, we'll start the battle and pause it, because I want to get everyone doing what they need to do as quickly as possible. So, start, pause. Right, you guys can jump there. You guys can jump there. You guys are going to go there. Our battering ram here. Alerts. You're just going to kind of keep these guys safe for the time being. Okay, let's go. And you are firing back.
Positions.
Okay. submit, considering how old this game is, it really does look fantastic. Oh, getting some serious amount of flak from these arrows. Archers, I want you to focus on these guys here because they're giving us absolute hell right now. I'm gonna need this Batarang to make it. They seem to know who to focus on as well, which is slightly worrying. Not the greatest shots, but the Batarang's made it, so hopefully... Let's go. Okay, so...
The battering ram is in place.
Finally getting some purchase on the walls over here. And there's absolutely no one holding us back, so we should be able to take the gate area. Flank them from that point of view, unless these guys start running up on the walls. But as far as I'm aware, there is absolutely no one apart from these guys here, but they don't seem to be doing anything at all. So I'm pretty content to let these guys take out these archers, which are currently driving us up the wall. Literally. Let's get... I think I'm going to bring Lurts in as well. And now these... Now Group 1 is kind of out of serious danger. I think I'm going to bring them a little bit closer so we can get a little bit more... A little bit more cover. Right, you guys are smashing these, so I want you guys to peel off. Take out his archers over here. What else have we got to deal with in here? So, have they left anyone back at the main? They haven't. Okay, so this is literally the bulk of their army is here. You guys. Help these guys out up here. I thought we took the gate. Okay. Took their general out. That's always nice. What does Uruk Tide do? Kind of want to try it out. Okay, the Berserkers are going Berserk. And our archers are taking out any stragglers that happen to try and get out of it, which is quite a nice little touch there from them, I think.
Activate
Okay, you guys. I want you guys to help up here. We'll let Lert deal with any stragglers going back to the main. Our archers are making pretty short work of them, but hopefully a nice wall of berserkers might finish them off.
Only half the enemy force remains.
It was a nice little volley there, wasn't it? Okay. How are we doing up here? Right, so we crushed these guys pretty much. They are trapped. Still getting a lot of arrows from these towers though, which is kind of irritating. Do we have to capture these towers? You guys are almost out of arrows now, aren't you? You guys are out of arrows, in fact. Where can I put you guys? Come over here. You guys, also come over here. You guys are done. So if I just... I'm going to get everyone on the walls over here. Finish off these guys. Yeah, you are still fighting. Right, you should be able to move up now. Come on, guys. Numbers are worth pretty much nothing here. There's got to be another way up on these walls. Please. Need you to come over here. Okay, come out here first. I need you to flank. Which means I need you to get off the walls first.
Our men are in command. Our men no longer command the castle.
Why not? Get back in there. What is going on there? Okay. I wasn't particularly happy about being killed, I'd say.
The battle is very much in our favour.
Animations are fantastic on these guys. Okay. Come over here. Good. Leave no survivors, shall we? There's a building there, guys. Come on. Come on. Not that silly, are you? Come on, guys. Come on. Hurry up. I haven't got all day. These towers are brutal. They really are. Like, Come on, hurry up. What is now? Are you gonna Yes. Perfect, that's what we need.
The battle is very much in our favour. Victory will be ours.
And then hopefully we should be able to cut them off. Wow. Joe, I can't wait to play the Helm's Deep map on this. Perfect. I think we should finish them off, in all fairness. They're trapped. They've got nowhere to go. We can capture them down here as well and sell them for ransom. Or just murder them. It's completely up to us, but I think ransoming them is probably a good idea. Not sure who to, though, in fairness. And we're done. Silence upon the battlefield. Oh, well, we're going to have to wait until these guys have captured it, even though we've destroyed every single person now. There we go. Perfect. So, we lost 149 men. They lost 402. So that's a pretty good kill-death ratio, in all fairness. So, let's continue. So, we've taken our first territory by force. So that means we now have three territories in the map, all of them covering the gap of Rohan, meaning that there's now no support for Rohan to the west, which is a pretty nice place to be, in all fairness, because Rohan are going to be a serious thorn in my side, and I'd rather than not have any help from near their elven king. Plus, obviously, we have the ability now to stop the One Ring coming that way, which I don't know how the script works on that, if that's still the case. I don't know whether it's physically moving, or if it's just something that just keep popping up. I'm not really sure. Okay, so let's occupy the settlement. So, let's get a better look at the map. How much close could we get? Okay, there. So, this is how we're looking. So for a first episode, I'd say that's pretty good. So what I'm going to do, just finish off these turns. Yes. So I'll grab these people, throw them up here.
Continuing tomorrow.
Just check Isengard quickly. So we now have our mines been built, so we have a lot of income now coming from Isengard. Can we build anything new here? Leather tanner, so we can get better men from this particular. So I think we'll build that there. We've got plenty of money coming in right now, so I have no issue with building something like that. Okay. So we can get quite a bit from here. So is there anything here that's going to make us some money? Garrison quarters, what's that built? Urukai raiders, reavers. There's nothing money-wise in here, I don't think. So we're going to go for garrison quarters on this one. Get some troops training there. And here... I need to move Grima, don't we? So Grima is currently on the shores. So we're going to move him towards Dolgdor. Apparently he is able to walk on water, which is quite surprising. And then once he is there... Here. Slightly worrying that's green. Does that mean Dolgdor has been taken? I'm in the right place, aren't I? Maybe not. Okay, we'll see. Okay, so that's it for this episode then, guys. So thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you can. And I'll see you in the next episode.